So, some derivatives. For example, fx equals e to the x. That's the beautiful function. F prime, the derivative would be e to the power x. I have another video where you can see when it's going crazy and you should have to pay attention, like 2 times e to the power x squared. So the derivative would be 2 times e x squared times 2x, because you have to do the multiplication with the derivative of the exponent. The easy ones are fx equals 2 x squared, f prime would be 2x, or you're going a little bit crazy, like 3x to the power 4 minus 2x plus 7. The derivative would be 12x to the power 3 minus 2. A lot of people are asking, what about the 7? The 7 is just the number, but it's not in a multiplication with x. It's just plus or minus. So you can say it's going away. If you have a number in a multiplication with x, the only thing you have to write down is the number itself. For example, I try to make it very simple. Fx, f prime x. If you have 3x, derivative would be 3, 4x would be 4, 200x, 200 minus x. Some are going crazy here. It would be minus 1 times x, so minus 1. What about 12x to the power 3? This is the formula. If you have a number, let's call the number c times x to the power n, and you're looking for the derivative, it would be n times c times x to the power n minus 1. Here is f of x, and this would be the derivative. So you take the exponent in the multiplication with the number in front, and the exponent here, in this case it's 4, minus 1 is 3. Pay attention, if you have fx would be like x to the power minus 5, the derivative would be minus 5 times, some of you say here's nothing, it would be 1 times x to the power minus 5. So minus 5 times 1 is minus 5 times x, and minus 5 minus 1 is minus 6. A lot of people write down minus 4, because 5 minus 1 is 4, but it's minus 5 minus 1 is minus 6. So some functions should be easy.